Welcome to this M2 Technologies Tech Tip. Today we'll be exploring how EdgeCam's machine feature command can be used to quickly build toolpath for common features. While this tech tip shows a milling application, the concept shown applies to both turning and milling. This turning exercise picks up with a model prepared for machining. Notice the model has features already created. We'll add on the features window temporarily to see some of those items. Notice that there are things such as external bosses, pockets, holes, and other geometric items. These features capture solid model intelligence and are easily usable to build toolpath. Users could create toolpath by going through all the steps required and building the events themselves, either using, in this case, mill cycles on this mill part or the operations. Today we're going to explore how to build toolpath even faster using EdgeCam's automatic machining. In this case, the machine feature command is the command that we're going to use to speed up the toolpath building process by leveraging the smart information already contained in the features. This command is very simple to use. It begins with some simple directives of what we want to do. In this case, I'm not going to use the current tool and select to do roughing work, and then after pressing OK, select the feature to target. We can either select the feature graphically from the list as I'm doing here, or directly from the features window. Once the feature is selected, and we continue, the software then goes through a decision-making process of choosing appropriate tooling and building a machining process. The events that are produced here are exactly the same events that would be built if we had built the pieces ourselves, just much faster. Those events are fully editable. We can go into them and select different tooling, change cutting parameters, or anything that we want. Notice that in this case, the machining process that's been built starts with a half-inch cutter and then works through progressively smaller cutters because the half-inch cutter is too large to completely remove all the material from the shape. We do need to ultimately use some very small cutters to handle the fillet requirements of this part. The process will work. If we wanted to further influence it, one of the things that we can do is by going underneath Plan into Options, there are user-definable parameters that control the decision-making and add extra influence. Things such as the amount of XY offset to leave on the shape, for example, or our cutter compensation preferences for finishing work. In this case, though, we're not going to use any of that. What we're going to do here is we're going to select the cutter that we intend to use, a quarter inch in this case. And with the quarter inch tool selected, next we're going to go back to machine feature and this time tell the software to use the tool we've already selected. This is going to bypass the software's decision making loop and create a very different process based on the tool that we have intentionally chosen. I'll select the same feature to machine and then let the software build toolpath. As before, the software goes and automatically builds toolpath much faster than I could have done it myself. But in this case, it just continues with the current tool and builds a single roughing cut. I could then continue to other pockets in the part if I wished. And I could, for example, select additional pockets. I'll pick two more in this case and finish, and that will continue to use the same tool and add additional pocket cuts for those features. One of the underlying questions many users ask is, am I in control of the process? And with machine feature and the use current tool, you are in a great deal of control. Simply pick the cutter you wish to use and then build the tool path. If I wanted to continue on to finishing work, for example, I could do finishing work with this same tool, but on the outside of the part, for example. And although that might not be a standard processing method that many shops would use in some materials, if that's the decision that I want to do here, that decision's immediately put into place, and the software is also intelligent enough to automatically avoid putting the tool through the fixturing. Again, I can edit the tool path, and I can step in and make additional modifications if I wish. These are machining events that are no different than if I had created the events myself. It's just much faster. Now, I want to point out that the software has a great deal of model information through the features. Working from the Features tab, I'll add the Properties window to the screen, and I'll select this pocket feature that we've been working with. Notice that the software already knows a great deal of information. such as that there's a quarter inch of material removal. It's a blind pocket. The smallest XY radius is roughly 50 thousandths, and there are no sharp internal corners. Based on this type of information, the software is able to select appropriate tooling and is able to build suitable path for roughing, finishing, hole drilling, roughing and finishing turn parts or bores in a lathe part or grooves or other common applications where features for mill and turn parts can be used. The point is that since the software already has this, why not put it to use? One of the Toolpath accelerators that gets this done very easily is the machine feature command. The machine feature command uses machining strategies which are installed with EdgeCam to quickly build functional toolpath. There are others. Strategies, macros, and masks are each unique toolpath accelerators available to EdgeCam users. Imagine each as a bucket, providing end users with access to useful software automation tools. But don't be alarmed by the word automation. You don't need to be a software developer to leverage them. Each bucket serves a very useful purpose, and you can utilize any of the software automation tools. The most productive users leverage all of these throughout their CAM process. This training segment is focused on machining strategies, which are the engine behind EdgeCam's automatic machining capability. The terms knowledge-based machining and feature-based machining are popular buzzwords. EdgeCam's factory installed machining strategies incorporate the best of both to analyze solid model geometry and build toolpath which reuses a proven process. EdgeCam's machining strategies definitely are toolpath accelerators. The recommendation here is to use EdgeCam's automatic machining to easily build baseline toolpath for common part features. Toolpath can be edited to dial it into the exact process needed, just like users would do with toolpath they built themselves. This approach is very fast and is very easy for CAM users of any experience level. This approach is also ideal for companies focused on program standardization, particularly across departments with multiple CAM users. It is also possible for end users to refine these machining strategies so that proven toolpath is built for common part geometry. For example, consider hole drilling. Many holes in customer parts do not require an engineering meeting to determine a suitable machining process. Instead, most CAM users can choose suitable tools and create toolpath without much thought. What if your CAM software could simply build that toolpath for you? EdgeCam Strategy Manager allows users to capture and reuse their proven process. Think of this as having your own programming assistant, able to think through toolpath building for common part geometries exactly as you would. EdgeCam can include nearly every component needed for production CNC milling, turning, and WireDM in the CAM system. The software simply needs a knowledgeable user to oversee the process. EdgeCam's toolpath accelerators offer the benefits of automation without taking critical control away from you.